On, we have interesting news regarding Chris D'Elia. You know, somebody I've covered a lot on my show in general. It looks like he's got some good news finally. Finally, a bit of good news, or you know, depending on how you view these sort of things. But this is courtesy of Radar Online. Woman drops lawsuit accusing comedian Chris D'Elia of possessing child porn. That's a heavy allegation to put out there about somebody, isn't it? So this article says the following. The woman who sued Chris D'Elia, accusing him of possessing child POR, has dropped the federal lawsuit against the comedian. According to court documents obtained by Radar, the woman using the pseudonym Jane Doe informed the court that she was dismissing all claims against D'Elia. So it's not even as if he paid her off. This is her saying, you know what, I can't go through with this. It continues, the document read that plaintiff Jane Doe and her counsel hereby give notice that the above entitled action is voluntarily dismissed without prejudice against the defendant. The without prejudice means Doe could refile the claims at a later date. So maybe she's just got cold feet, she got, you know, terrible anxiety, trolls DM'd her, who knows. But from what it looks like, she decided that this wasn't worth going forward with and just pulled the plug. Now, does that call into question whether or not whether she accused D'Elia of actually happened? I definitely think it does. But does that absolve him completely when he's looking at all the other accounts? Probably not. It continues. Back in March, Joe sued D'Elia, accusing him of violating federal child sexual exploitation and child P laws. In the suit, Doe said that she met D'Elia on Instagram in 2014. They eventually moved the conversation over to Snapchat, classic move. At that time, the comedian was 34 and Doe was 17. So what was she at best and what was she lying about age-wise? She said she was 19, 18. I imagine so, right? I'd imagine. It continues. The plaintiff said that D'Elia persuaded her to attend one of the shows in October 2014. Again with the shows. They're sort of luring. I remember, so who said it recently? I think Yanis Pappas maybe said it recently on the Your Mom House podcast about there is a weird correlation between how, you know, serial killers and comedians move or navigate in the world, right? It definitely is an odd one. They have these sort of rituals of where they take people in order to do certain things, like bizarre humans. It continues here. The plaintiff said D'Elia persuaded her to meet at one of the shows in October 2014. The two had reportedly had sex before the show, and allegedly the alleged counter D'Elia expressed that Miss Doe's age, innocence and virginity made the encounter hot. Doe claims that D'Elia solicited more than 100 sexual photos of her, I guess when she was underage, hence the porn exploitation thing. Half of these photos were taken when she was 17. She claimed that she requested additional videos showing her with a SEX toy and SEX with other boys her age. Mamma mia. She claims to have been a virgin before D'Elia, and the lawsuit also had unspecified damage, along with a court ordered releasing the alleged P images of he possessed of her. In a statement released after the filing, Doe said, "When I was in my final year of high school and still a child, I was groomed by a celebrity twice my age. Chris D'Elia abused his status and fame to lure me in, take advantage and manipulate me when I was a vulnerable age." There's a lack of accountability with this, isn't it, right? As if this like man dragon, no copyright when it comes to the Brian Callum, but there is a lack of accountability on both ends, right? There's a lack of accountability from the comedians that are being accused that they could ever have played a part in their own demise, and that their reckless actions and their pursuit for hedonism at all cost has eventually cost them both their careers in a big, you know, meaningful way, especially when you think of Brian Callum. But there's also no responsibility, it feels like, with some of these girls who purposely went out their way to hang out, exchange flirty messages with, and just in general be inappropriate with people that they probably should have no business talking to. Again, yes, some could argue the power and the maybe adultness of the situation should fall on the adults, and you should maybe, if somebody does come around who's not of age or somebody that you probably wouldn't want to be seen out in public with, it's your prerogative to basically tell them, hey, this ain't gonna happen, especially with your family and stuff, isn't it? Like, madness. It continues, Chris D'Elia abuses status that has lured me in. She said that I want other girls to know that they are not alone, and it's time to justice for the mental and physical toll he has put us through. At the time, a spokesperson for the comedian said Chris denies the allegations and vigorously defend himself against them in court. So what I'm thinking is that, can these sort of stains ever be removed from you? Is there ever a possibility in life where Chris can return to having some semblance of a career. I said before on the show a few times, I think he can. If he's not worried about being in Hollywood, he could easily go on tour and do that sort of stuff. Maybe do some guest appearances here and there. You know, whoever would be the first person to allow him on, I guess, is going to be the big hero. But that makes a lot of sense. But in terms of getting back into industry, that it doesn't matter what anyone says when they take it back. People are always going to feel like you did it, especially if you can't prove it without any doubt. That's the probably the hardest thing about this. But again, I guess it's probably good news for Chris D'Elia. I'm sure he's probably going to be ecstatic about this, you know, and he's going to have a chance to get out on the road and stuff, and maybe put to test some of these developments and growths he says he's kind of, you know, basically been able to go through during this crazy time. Let's see him put into action, right? When you actually go on the road and you're performing in front of a stage and there's a woman in the corner giving you the FU eyes, let's see if he actually abstains. Let's see.